Hi, I'm Don Clark of FileMakerProGurus.com and FM Database Consulting. Thanks for joining me today for FileMaker Pro Guru's Hot Tip Number 2, 8 things you should do before you start developing a project in FileMaker Pro. Let's get started. I'll bet some of you just jump right in and start developing right away. Why not? It's exciting. You can develop some pretty neat stuff really fast in FileMaker Pro, right? Wrong. If your goal is to build a tight, responsive database that meets the needs of your client, there's 8 things you need to do before you dive right in. Now, I know there's more than 8 things to do before you start a database, probably a lot more, but I'm referring to those critical things that any FileMaker Pro guru should do before they open up FileMaker Pro or FileMaker Pro Advanced. Doing so will help ensure that your database is properly designed and built and meets all your clients' needs, and more so, will do so elegantly. So without further ado, here's my 8 things you need to do before you start developing with FileMaker Pro. Number 1, ask your client to tell you a story. Your client may be internal like a boss or external like a business. Ask them to tell you a story about how they do what they do. Listen, ask questions. Listen some more. Ask some more questions. Repeat until you get a full and clear understanding of just what exactly it is your client needs and wants. Number 2, ask your client what kind of reports they want. This is a good way to dig deep into the data and root out the information that's really critical to you designing a good database. Finding out what kind of reports they want will allow you to figure out what data needs to be collected, what relationships are needed, and what kind of design considerations you're going to have to take into account. For example, your client might want a multiple page invoice that shows descriptive notes, and it expands to show those notes when they're present, but it shrinks to not show anything when they're not present. This tells you that you need to design line item notes into your invoicing system and that your customer has multiple page invoices, which is something you have to design for the beginning. Number 3, ask your client how many people will be using the database at the same time. Building a multi-user database solution requires that you address record locking, and that's an important design consideration. It'll also help you calculate the final cost of the solution. Number 4, ask if the solution will be client-based or if it's going to be server-based. If it's server-based, is it going to be local or is it going to be in the cloud? Is it going to be wired or wireless? How are people going to be hooking up to this solution? These issues will affect the reliability and the speed of the database, so they're important design considerations. It'll also help you spec out the hardware you need for the final solution. Number 5, how will the data be input? Typing, scanning, importing, ODBC, ESS, some combination of all of the above? Will it be coming from websites, other servers, emails, or some other types of machines? Will you need to design iPhone or iPad layouts? If so, are you going to have to synchronize the data or is it going to be hooked up live? Get detailed here. You're going to want to know what kind of hooks, interfaces, scripts, and layouts you're going to have to develop to make the solution work properly. 6, ask about security. Find out how many levels of security are going to be needed and whether or not you're going to have to build in logging. Also ask about record locking. For example, when an invoice is submitted or when a journal entry is processed, those items can't be changed. They have to be locked. You need to know this. Number 7, how will existing processes be changed by the database? Make suggestions here. Your client is counting on you to help make these improvements. For example, your client might benefit from barcode scanners instead of using a drop-down list when they're entering information in an invoicing system. Be careful to explain to them how that will benefit them, how much it's going to cost, and how much it's going to save them in the long run. The reality is you know what FileMaker can do, and they know what they need done. Together you can craft a FileMaker solution that'll knock their socks off and turn them into a raving fan. And raving fans are good to have. Number 8, summarize what you've learned and read it back to the client. This is critical. This will ensure that you're both on the same page. Restating the project succinctly often reminds the client of something that they left out, and now's the time to find that out. So there's my list of 8 things to do before you start a project in FileMaker Pro. You probably have a list of your own, and I'll bet you it's pretty similar to this one. What's important is that you have a list that you cover it completely. Ask more questions and collect more information as the situation dictates. Now it's time to gather all the information that you've collected and retreat to your favorite FileMaker lair and start planning your database. data modeling, making an entity relationship diagram, and so on. But those are subjects for future videos. Learn more on this topic and other topics at FileMakerProGurus.com. Just click the button at the bottom of the screen and you'll find hundreds of more articles and lots of topics that'll help you in every phase of your project. I'm Don Clark of FileMakerProGurus.com and FM Database Consulting. I'm glad you were able to join me today. Please don't forget to like the video and also to subscribe to my channel. Thanks, and I'll see you next time.